This is Tom, and today I'm going to talk about what this Mimi litter has to do with these salt and pepper shakers from Walmart. I had heard and had seen a couple of videos saying that there were certain types of kitty litter that were pure silica gel. And when I noticed this stuff in the store, this 4-pound bag for about $5 at Walmart, it says it's porous silica sand. And even the brand name or the website is silica-gel.com. Of course, it's made in China. Of course, it's sold at Walmart, so it's made in China. Ha. But I needed something to hold this stuff in to use it as silica gel for keeping things dry. Camping gear, ammo, what have you. And so I thought of something like an old pepper shaker. I was going to go look for some used pepper shakers, maybe the plastic type, because they have the smaller holes, or the salt shakers, whichever has the smaller hole, and use those. And then I ran across these in Walmart, and they're a pack of 8 for $1.94. So I have 16 of those. Let's call that $4, and $5 worth of silica gel kitty litter. And so with less than $10, I have a long-lasting supply of something to help keep things dry. I'll make a funnel out of paper, put the silica gel or the porous silica sand inside of these shakers, and then place those inside of ammo cans and anything else that needs to be kept dry. If it works, great. It doesn't work, I'm not out of that much money, and it's cheaper than buying the silica gel packs online or trying to find silica gel that you don't know whether it's still of use or not. I would imagine I have to keep this stuff wrapped tightly, so after I open this bag, I'll have to maybe separate it out if it doesn't ziplock properly. I realized I can take a piece of scotch tape and place it across the top of the shaker to regulate how much air flows through, instead of just using the normal holes that are in the lid of the shaker. And once I do that, I can take it, close it up, I can take a pen and or needle and make as many holes in the cellophane or the scotch tape as I need to allow enough air to flow through to keep dry whatever it is I need. Of course, this will be trial and error. Now that I've placed the cellophane on and closed the cap on one of those, I've placed it inside of this ammo box. And it will stay there for a while, and I will look and see after a while how well it did. And it'll be, of course, trial and error. And for the ones that remain unused, I will put a piece of cellophane across the top of those, and I will place them in my handy-dandy peanut jar where I keep my other silica gel packs closed and recharged. And I don't know how that mess got on the table. That was here when I got here.